here in mid-April in Ontario. 2 days ago, it felt like South Carolina and Mississippi. 25, 26 degrees. I heard stories of guys catching all kinds of big crappie, big bluegill, sunfish, perch, everything was going. Well, guess what? We're out, and last night down to -3. My boat cover was frozen this morning on the boat. What am I gonna do? And how am I gonna catch these cold front crappie? I'm gonna slow down, small little tubes, little grubs. I'm not gonna do anything in a hurry. Find maybe the bigger fish by slowing down, put some coffee scent on the baits, vary my depths and stuff. But the biggest thing is getting my bait right in front of their nose. Crappie are not the smartest thing in the world. You know what? If you put your bait where it should be, right in front of their nose, sometimes touching it, just out of impulse, like a smallmouth, they'll suck it in. But, you know, you go to areas that look fantastic and think, man, they should be here, and you're not getting bit, they might be there. But you just gotta learn to slow down when you get these kind of conditions. Cold front mornings in the water in the high 30s. Seriously, that's cool. But we're gonna get out there, gonna do what we gotta do to catch fish so you can do it too. Let's go. I talked about preparation. You know, the night before, especially on cold days and stuff, you don't want to be playing around first in the morning trying to put a lead head into a tube jig and stuff. Be prepared. It only takes a few minutes, you know, before you go out. So I got different rods set up, different lengths with some grubs, different size floats, different size tubes, different colors and stuff. So I have some variety. That's the thing. Let the fish tell you what they want. You'll be better off in the long run because you catch more and bigger fish. Which one's going to be hot? This one? Anything with chartreuse usually is a ticket. I'll take a few out so I'm prepared and ready. Another thing, you see me just pulling line out. It's way much easier than always casting, retrieving, casting, retrieving. My rod's 10 feet long. I got about 15 feet of line. I can drop it in the holes, watch it. And I use my other hand to swim the jig like this and to feel those subtle bites sometimes. See, there was a fish right there. Wow, watch this. And just swim it and pop it and pull it out, drop it in. And I'm only fishing, you know, 15 feet ahead of the boat, not far. This is hand-to-hand crappie contact. One-on-one. You, your rod, line, and little jig. Hope you some big slabs. Look at the size of these ones, oh my God. Got them. See? If you're patient, you get them. Dunking. Decided to pick up my long pole, put a few in maybe for the live well, see if we get any bigger ones for pictures. That's why I got 5 foot rods, 6 foot, 7 foot, sometimes 9 and 10. Going in stealth-like, no float, just me, rod, line, small tube, dunking into little clumps. It's a whole different way to fish. It's like fishing for bass, hunting them down. Once you find them, 50-50. Put it on their nose, either they spook or they eat it. Let's keep going and hopefully get some real good ones doing this. It's more looking than anything. Look at these clumps. This is what they sit in. Sometimes, I'll come up with the long rod. Watch this. See the slop here? Crappie love to hide underneath that stuff. All of a sudden, he'll come out if he's there. I can put it right in the hole, ready? Right in there, look. They hide just like bass. You put it in and shake it a bit. If they're there, they'll tell you. I can turn around, I'm a little shallow, and keep that sun on my back so I can see in the water. Let's keep moving. Man, you gotta put it right in front of their nose. See? Just like that. Ooh. Sometimes they pop off. Doesn't matter. Hunting them down. I love it. As soon as you see them, and it's pendling the bait coming like this, they're just chasing it real slow, close to their mouth. So cool. So cool way to catch them. Going too
quick. Oh, I got spooked. All sparse. Then I see a little clump of weed. There's a good chance there's gonna be some fish. One fish, three, five. With crappie, that's the thing, they're schooling fish. So if you see one, there's a good chance there's more. If you pop it and miss a fish, put it right back in the same spot. A lot of times you just gotta put that in the right spot, another one will come over and eat it. Huge crappie, huge crappie. Don't move, don't move. There he is right there, look at him. Wow. Oh. Right here. Oh God, he keeps swimming. Look at him, right there in the sand. Look at the size of him. Oh, why didn't he eat it? Look at the size of that one. Got him. See? See what happens when you wait? Patience is a virtue. Respectable, isn't it? Fantastic meal. You don't need a lot of these. I'm telling you, they're so fun to catch. And it was freezing cold this morning. I mean, deadly cold. Sun came up, found a little back canal. It's warm. Here they are. Now we're catching a few. Let's keep going. Dunking. Look at that. Little fruity tooty tube. And just stocking them down. I'm telling you. This is the way I love to fish for crappie, because it reminds me very much of bass. And you know what? Love bass. Look at the size of those crappie. Oh, God. Boy, he flashed like he was going to eat it. Here he comes. Ready? Got him. See? When you wait, when you're patient, you'll get him. There's a couple there, and you're patient. Look where he's got it too. Fruity tootie, eh? Boy, oh boy. It is the best of both worlds, this kind of fishing. You know why? I love it when it comes together. Seeing so many of these in front of you that get spooked. That's the worst of this. But if that's the worst, hey, you know what? It's fishing. Not every time can you go, just cast a float, wait to go down, set, set, set. We all love to do that. Sometimes you gotta hunt them down. It's freezing cold this morning. Sun's finally up. Still not real hot, just comfortable. Comfortable spring day catching black crappie in a little cut. Keep going. Maybe get a few more for dinner. And it's just like dunking for bass. You know they're there. You got faith they're there because you see them. But they're much more susceptible when you make those short pitches ahead of the boat. You don't see them, they don't see you. Now, they're not the smartest creatures in the world. You saw them catching someone and putting it on their nose. But when you get different guys fishing, you know, you share the waterway. It's not so much that they're catching the fish where you are. Sometimes you just get spooked. When they get spooked, they get weary. I like them when you just take the line out like this, pop it out, and see them come. Boom! Just eat it. It's like a bass coming out of his little ambush spot. Like right there. Wow, that was a small one, but still. A little clump, and out they come. Amazing. They're right about there. Come on, over and eat it, boys. You know you want it. Oh yeah, there's a couple good ones there. I see them now. Oh boy. Boy, the ones that don't want to eat it, they're so, I don't know what you want to say, man. Stubborn. The bait goes right by their nose. They're just like, won't even move like a statue. Then you get it by some other ones, they just charge it, whoosh, and eat it. When you get other guys working in here, fishing in here, you got to share the waterway, obviously. You just got to wait it out. Wait it out, like right there. Wait it out, put it in front of them. Wait for those bigger slabs to come over and eat it. Right there. See? He's not one of the bigger slabs. Crappie, you were meant to come home, weren't you? Yes. I'm probably not going to get a lot doing this. I'm going to keep a couple for dinner. Let's put them in the live well, huh? Still, just a few little slabs off him. A couple little fillets. I got a 9-foot and 10-foot. This is a 10-foot. St. Croix panfish series. Two piece. The reason I got these wasn't so far to casting and stuff. I used the 7-footers for that. For me, this is all about this game, dunking in shallow water. I'm gonna get a big slab if I keep doing this right here. Drift down like this through this stuff. Let's hope. Look at him. Oh yeah, we're in that clump. Look at him. Yes, yes, yes. See what I mean? Look how far down. That's how you want those crappies to eat it. He sees that come by the clump. They are not the smartest creatures in the world. He's just sitting by a piece of cover. Look at that. That's why you got these sharp hooks. Look at that, eh? See what I mean? Just a gorgeous, beautiful eating size fish. I love catching the real big guys, just for the sake of getting a big prize, you know what I mean? Catching big lunker fish. But those crappie, eating crappie right there. Gonna be surrounded with fries and lemon wedges a little later on. And even though the canal has got all kinds of boats in it, all kinds of people fishing, just goes to prove you can still catch them. If you slow down, take off that float, pick up that little tube, just put it in right, all the right spots. We've seen some big ones in here, boy. Love to catch. Good one. There we go. Another little decent one, eh? Comes out of those clumps. What does he do? He says hello to the camera. Wow, man. Just dinner plate size, eh? Just good for eating. But this sense, it's more of a sense of accomplishment. Cold day, and I thought, who knows? But you know what? When you get them like that, at the first thing in the morning, freezing cold, take what the lake gives you. That's what it's giving me today. This is what I'm talking about right here. There's another one. Oh God. Look at that. That's exactly what I'm talking about. Doesn't matter how many guys are in the canal, where you are, fish it right, catch them. That. Just like that. Going through the same stuff as all these guys. Same traditional stuff. Float. But I'm just putting it in isolated spots. What happens? Catch crappie. Put them in a box. A couple more and we're almost done. Man, there's some good clumps right here. Holy moly. Are they out here? Have they been spooked? Well, that's another day. Came out this morning, awfully freezing cold, -3. 2 days ago, 25 degrees. What happens to the crappies? Whew, tight-lipped. Persevered, traveled the float first thing this morning. A few small fish, little fish, nothing to brag home about. And, some bluegills and sunfish and stuff, but that's not what I'm after here. I want to catch some slabs. Got him. See? Put down the traditional 5-foot to 7-foot ultralights with the floats. Picked up my little tutti frutti, a 9-foot little jigging stick, which means I can just cane pole it down, back and forth. The guys do that a lot in Mississippi and Tennessee. Single rod, just jigging. All visible cover. In this case, it was just those little clumps in about 2.5 feet of water. Little depressions went down about 2.5, but those clumps, you just had to believe the fish were there. So, made the best of a freezing day. See? Sometimes, put down the traditional stuff, pick up the different stuff, single pole it, catch one at a time, but work at it.
It's beautiful. A fantastic day to be alive and fishing for crappie. But you know, the temperatures are 39.5. So you know, the ice just came off, I don't know, a week and a half ago. And that's on the surface. So what is it down 5, 10, 15 feet? Those fish are maybe suspending on things, weed, maybe rocks or different things. But today we're gonna play out an area of this lake with what I call pop and stop. I mean, what do you mean? You think the fish are gonna be really cold? And obviously they are, you know, almost like in a winter mode, just hovering, looking for heat, anything.
you know, school together on weeds and rocks and things like that, you know. But I always believe in triggering a bite. So suspended floats vary it depending on how deep the fish are in the water column. With this high sun, they might just be triggered to come higher in the water column. So what I'm gonna do is cast out, let the float settle, a little pop and stop. Pop and stop. And you think that, well, it's a triggering effect. I believe all fish, when they're aggressive, it's easy to catch. But when they're subtle, when they're just dormant, or just not in the mood to eat, you gotta trigger them. And even these ice cold crappie, you can still trigger them, but just pop and stop with a little shad pole, the little ball in the tail, and just leave it there. Patience is the key to this stuff. So we're gonna go out, have a great day, and hopefully you will learn that early spring with the pop and stop will catch crappie for you. Let's go have some fun. Spot number one, we're gonna fish some deep weeds off a little rock pile, and I got the slip float about, oh, that's at least 5 feet. And you see that little, goes up and down and slide, and I got a little split shot as well, so that float will sit as vertical as possible. But we're gonna try to find the location of those fish, use our marker buoys, and hopefully just stay back. And because the thing is, if we find fish sitting on, let's say, a pocket of weed, and you keep drifting over it, you gotta turn the trolling motor around and you keep thrusting. It's not a good idea. The best thing is just to stay back and then keep thrusting up the trolling motor and make your cast a bit longer. Let's see. I'm gonna set my float even deeper.
Oh, there's a fish.
You got him?
Yeah.
Good size?
Oh, looks like it. Oh yeah, I'm gonna keep one of the other
side. Good one?
Nice fish, nice starter fish, okay. That's for sure. Look at that.
Make sure you can see it then. Perfect. There nice stuff. Go. I knew I had a bite there too.
Yeah, look at that.
Atta boy.
That's exactly what you're looking for. Right after ice out, beautiful fish.
Did he after you popped it?
Yep.
Nice.
Twitch, twitch, pop, pop, bang.
Right on. Now when we casted, you know, you just move it, let the float settle, let it go down to the bobber stop, the float's in the right spot. That way you know your bait is vertically, straight down. And like I said, I added a bit more length to my bobber stop for that pendulum of the wind pushing the bait, okay, on the float. But I mean, just a little twitch, not much. Little twitch of the handle, that's all you had to do. So the float just moved and then settled again. Moved, settled again. And it was a triggering effect that made those crappie bite. Make it even deeper, find where they are. I don't know, you're about the same.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's that, get that little bit of that warm wind, that'll get them going.
Mm-hmm. Once we figure out right on where they are.
Yeah. I think right where your cat, yeah, there.
Right there. Crappie time. Oh, look at that, nice one too.
Nice one, Carl.
Look how thick that is, eh? Wow.
Oh.
I just popped it too.
Yeah.
Whoa, look at that. Look how he's got that too, let me show you that. He's got that slab slasher, man. Right in. I just popped it too, look where he got it. Like perfect. You talk about these hooks getting perfect placement.
Yep. Look at the flash on this thing.
Right on. Oh yeah.
Oh okay. Man. Can't
popping
beat that.
Popping and stopping.
Yeah.
That's what we get right there. I put this right one in the box for some pictures, huh?
Yeah.
Right on. Yes, sir. Nothing like figuring it out, boy. And you just gotta keep setting it. The depth back and forth. And we got a somewhat aggressive color. You know, the black is neutral, yeah. But the chartreuse.
Yeah, and I got a little purple on, but yeah. Still with that chartreuse.
Yeah, that's the deal. And the chartreuse heads.
Yeah.
And that little ball, eh?
Oh.
With the little vibration when you pop it, it just goes toot. I mean, just enough to trigger them to bite, eh?
And it's also the wave action. It keeps moving all the time.
Awesome little baits. Look at that. Let's go get some more.
There we go.
Attaboy. Feel good?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, look at that glare.
Oh.
There's another one.
Let's double it up, Carl.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. Look at that.
Look at this. Scary crappies, man.
Oh, yeah. Look at that, Carl.
Hey. On the right spot with the right baits, rods, and that the results. Look at that. I can't see enough about these hooks.
Yeah. You know what? I'll put them in for you.
How's that? Awesome, aren't they?
Double right on, headers. Man. Ice out crappie.
Love it.
Wow.
Man. Ice cold.
Oh yeah.
Beautiful fish. Whoa. Oh God, dude.
If you got a nice one?
Oh yeah. Oh, stay on, dude. Look at this, man.
Seriously.
All right, I'll get mine.
Oh, out. On this side. Dude, look at it. Look at it.
Oh, man. You need the net, Carl?
Yeah, for sure. Look at him.
Oh, he's coming out like a bass.
Thanks.
Yeah. It's hard. You know, I got a fish on. I got a net.
Oh, God, man.
Oh.
Look how he took that one. Whoa. Look at that. Look at that. I mean, there was no float going down. It was pulling my line. Pulling. Like, zip. It's like, oh, you wanted that, eh? Wow. I got to show you this. Look where he's got it. Seriously. When crappie decide to eat with that mouth, just, it's sick, man. Doop. Wow. Just poke it down. Lift it out. Wow.
And that's part of a double header.
Yeah, man. Look at the nice thick backs on them too.
Wow.
Just love these fish, boy. Have a good meal on some of these fish. And tell you what we're gonna do. We're gonna get a decent, the limit here in Ontario is 30 each, but there's no reason to keep 30. We'll keep about maybe 10 to 12 each. But as we get more bigger fish, take the smaller ones, call them out, conserve the fishery so they're here for you next time you come and your family and your kids can enjoy the exact same stuff you see that we're doing right here by popping and stopping for crappie. And figuring it out just means having the right depth. And here, again, here's the bobber stop. I'll show you how I put it on. Bobber goes down to my little split shots, keeps that float as vertical as it can be, and just slides up to wherever I want to stop it. That's the depth I'm fishing. Now I put it a little bit deeper, remember, because we got that wave action. So it's not going to be straight down below the float. It's going to be a bit of an angle like this. So I allow that for a bit more space of the stop, a bit higher, about a foot. So it allows that descent and that angle because of the wind. It goes right through their face and they eat it.
Yeah.
Got him?
Oh yeah.
Good one?
Feels nice.
Looks good.
Oh yeah. He's staying down. That's a good fish.
That looks like a big crappie, dude.
It is. Oh yeah.
Netter?
No, I'm gonna swing him, Carl.
You sure?
Oh, maybe not. You know what? No. Not today. Look at that.
Yeah.
Oh.
That's a beauty.
Man, oh man, look at that. Spring crappie in Ontario. Wow. Awesome.
Ha. How do you beat that?
You can't.
See where you see the red part? That's all I see above the water. So there's no resistance for those fish. When I pop it, and it starts to go and it settles. They feel no resistance. Just pulling that little balsa wood float right down, signals a bite, catch the fish. Right there. Oh my God. Look at, well, they turn, eh?
Oh yeah.
It's like, wow.
Double you up. Oh, Carl.
Gorgeous fish.
I got a nice one, Carl. Look at splish, splash.
They're just awesome, man. Perfect. Have a great meal.
Oh yeah.
Take some crappies home, huh? Oh boy. Eat up some crappies later.
How could you not like this?
Yeah, I know. I'm almost getting picky. I'm gonna let that one go.
I'm gonna let mine go too.
Okay.
Perfect.
Bye.
I took that risk. I switched the color to that electric chicken. My last one, it popped the bobber right up.
No
there we go.
No problem seeing that one. Whoa. Nice. Oh yeah, pull and drag, dude.
Okay.
This is a netter. Oh yeah. Look at that. There is a king slab.
Right there.
Look at that, dude. King slab.
Oh yeah.
My God, eh?
Look at that.
Wow.
Great, buddy.
There's what we're actually after right there. We call those king slabs. Look at that. He got jabbed, look at, by either a cormorant or a pike or something. Look at that. He's got a big mark on his back. I'll show you there. Look at this. He got slashed, eh? Wow. Beautiful black crappie. Ontario's own. You know, 24 karat gold. I love crappie fishing, man. You can tell. Put them in there. Oh, man. Twitch, twitch. I got that float perfectly set now. When you take your eyes off it, where is it? But so when they eat it, it's just no resistance. And the waves moving it like this, back and forth, and just descent. When they decide to eat it, don't worry. They won't let go. Let's go. You talk about fun. Crappie fishing, why do I do it? Seriously. It tastes fantastic, but man, camaraderie, friendship, and just something about catching
crappie, having fun, laid back. If you lose them, who cares? But I mean, when you get it dialed in, the right system, a presentation, and they school up like that, they're making memories for a lifetime.
Yeah.
Like right there?
Yeah.
Right there too.
Nice one.
Nope. That looks pretty big.
Oh man, I got another. Oh, Carl.
Yeah, a netter.
Yeah, you got the net here?
Yeah, hold on, let this guy fight.
Oh, look at the size of this thing.
Yeah, that's tanky. That's a tanky.
Oh man, that's bigger than the last one.
Yeah.
Oh! Come on, Carl, this is the way to do it.
Way to go. That's the way to do it, with a pop and stop, okay? When they're freezing cold.
Yeah.
And you catch monsters like this, and something like that.
But look how he ate it.
Oh yeah.
There's nothing, look at that.
Wow.
You think he's hungry?
There you have it. A morning of crappie fishing in northeastern Ontario with the pop and stop. The brand new poles with that little shad pole. Twitching it, making the float twitch, twitch, getting the reaction strike from crappie that are sitting in that ice cold water weed. Next time you want to go out early spring, natural lakes, trust your instincts by provoking strikes. Cold front crappie in spring. I'm going to show you how I fish them with the slip bobber and little shad bait. We're going to pick a little back bait. That's the warmest water we can find. In springtime, those crappies get right in that stuff here up in Ontario, Texas and Oklahoma and stuff. There's different areas, different ways they fish for them, single poling. You know, they still use a float, but it's a very popular technique and presentation to catch them. We set it up with a slip float here, and you got a little bobber stop that you put on. So it affects how far up the float will go up, then that affects how deep you're fishing. So that there is about 24 inches, okay? The area I'm gonna be fishing is about 4.5, between 3 to about 5 feet, I'd say. So about 4.5 feet. So I'm gonna start with the float a little deeper, about 36 inches. And I'm vary that depending on the bites, the depth I'm at. I always wanna keep this little bait above the crappie's face so he sees it. I don't like to have to make them go down. They will eat down, but I like to have them just look up and go boom, and grab it. Little shad baits I'm gonna use just look like real small little profile. 1/16th ounce jig heads. Nope. Whoa, 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 whoa. Don't need to be crappie on that tree. I wanted to save that for single poling fishing, but when you're catching them, decent little fish, little pans, eh? They're like round. They're not long, these crappie. They're like round. You know, they're not long. Beautiful little fish. Fix up my float. I got the poles down and just push it up against that little 1/16th ounce jig head. You know what? It's too shallow. Or I mean, I'm too deep. See that grass I got in the bottom? I don't know if that was from that branch, but I think that's only like, 2.5 feet deep. And I want to stay above the fish's head. So I'll just shorten it up a little bit by about 5 inches. Let's try the outside edge here. Right on that tip of the tree there. Yep, oh, good one too. Whoa, where are you going? Hey? They're almost like all twins in here. Look at, it's the 11 inch club. 11 inches of crappie. Black and gold. Hey? Just good eating size crappies right there, boy. You know them big ones I like to catch and take pictures of, but those right there. So here's what I'm doing here too, because that tree's tapering down. In this channel, I'm sitting in 4 feet of water. So obviously the deeper edges, they like to see this deeper stuff here. If I was single poling, I bet I can get them way up inside there, but holding the pole right down right below the surface. But these ones that are eating the little plastic, they're right on the tip of this tree at the deepest section, at the point of it right there. Let's see if there's any more there. Man, they bury right in. When they eat it, they turn right around and try to go right back in there.
can almost feel the brush sometimes when I'm fighting them. See? Wow, eh? Look how they scrap. Wow. Man, catching crappies, man. I just love it. Look where he's got it here, too. Look at that. Huh? Right through the side, past the membrane. Getting a sharp little jig hook right there. That's right there, a little bit more than a handful. Ready? Go on. Little shad bait, just a little shad bait. Streamlined little thing with a little tail. And you can see how it just shakes in the water when I shake it. I just shake it, you know? Get it up straight, line it up. A little tail, even the wind, it's moving and stuff. Little white jig head. That is black crappie. You see that? Out a bit further. Oh, nice one too. Oh, wow. Wow. Bobbers and shad baits. Wow. Right in the hard part where it's like, you know, he's coming in the boat. Tell me that's not fun, eh? Seeing that little float just twitch, boom, so I caught some different species, caught some pike, and all of a sudden, the crappies decide to wake up. And that's the thing with crappie fishing. You get one going, it's like the whole school decides, hey man, there's minnows here, let's eat them. Can I pull another one out of here? How many got stung mouths? How many went back? Yep. Whoa. Oh boy. Walter was in there. Look at. On the outside edge, man. Oh. Eating the soft shad bait. Look at that. Is that a handful or what? Wow. Tell me that isn't fun crappies, man. Right past the membrane. That's why I use those jig heads that are a little bit more set back. I'll take a few pictures of that one. We'll let her go. But man, oh man. Got the poles down. Casting to it. I pulled her off there. Or him off. Let's see. No, look at the skinny little belly. That's a male. So be patient. Keep moving around. Stay on the trolling motor. Look down the sonar. Watch your depths and stuff. Remember where you caught the first fish, 3 to 5 feet of water. And keep replicating that in the same areas you are. And you'll keep catching them just like this. There you have it. An afternoon. Slip bobbers and small little plastic baits, catching crappies like there's no tomorrow, in a few little pods, some jack of all trades, one here, one there. We found a little pocket of fish, caught some fish, had some fun. Think of the plastics, think of the bobbers, think of crappie.